Hey guys, what is up? The Neocubist here. Welcome to my simple starter Oak Forest house tutorial. It's a really cool two-story house, and it's definitely starter, so it's not too hard to build and just take starter materials. It's got a pretty interesting inside. It's not, you know, the best, but it is a starter build. Keep that in mind. So yeah, let's get to the tutorial. Alright, so for your starter Oak Forest House tutorial, you're going to need to find the materials found on my hotbar below, and you're going to want to copy this shape right here. The wool is just there for your measurement, so if you guys want to just like use that there, that's a 9x9 square of oak wood on the outside, and just pause it right here. Alright, I'm going to assume that you have done that. If not, I would go back and definitely copy that, because that's going to make it a lot easier to build. Typically, when you have the base of your build, it's going to make it a lot easier. The first step is going to be lining these logs with a top layer of oak leaves all the way around. Again, this will fit in a 9x9 plot. This entire thing is 9x9. These oak leaves are a 9x9 square. So, believe it or not, it's like Ripley's Believe It or Not. You just gotta believe and hope that it's the truth, right? So, that's the next step. It's going to be filling in that with cobblestone. This is gonna be your entryway right here. We're gonna build these up to be a total of 4 high. So, we're gonna add on 3 blocks on top of these right here. And then we're going to fill in the walls with some oak wood planks. Just like that. Pretty simple to do. Not hard. I don't think, at least. Maybe it is hard. Let me know in the comment section below if laying down oak wood planks is hard for you guys. I want to know. I really do. And that's not sarcastic. Pause it right here. Let me know if laying down oak wood planks is hard. Alright. Thank you. If you did it, thank you. If you didn't, nah, that's alright. I'm not offended. I don't think. Maybe. Should I be offended? Maybe. Alright. So, right here. You're just going to build this up 3 higher, and then we're going to do that as well. Just on these blocks right here, you just want to make that a total of 3 high. Next step is going to be lining out your next layer, like next floor layer. So we're just going to do that, and we're just going to fill all of this in with some oak wood slabs on the top block. Now, some of these aren't actually going to be like the top layer, but it's just going to be nice to fill them in, just because, you know. Just because, you know. So now we're gonna come down here, and we're gonna put a full block. Then we're gonna put some cobblestone right here first of all, and then we're going to put 2 fence gates. And then we're gonna come in here. We're gonna take some stairs, just like this, upside down preferred. And we're gonna take a door, made of oak wood. There was an oak wood door right there. Nope, there actually isn't a door. That's fine. We don't really need a door because honestly, it's not gonna be that useful. We're gonna go ahead and fill all of this in right here with just some oak wood. We're gonna take a ladder. And we're going to get up to the second floor via the ladder right here. And we're going to have to design this roof now. So I'm going to grab those materials and I will be right back. Well, before we get to the roof, guys, we're going to have to remember that we got to connect the tops right here. So take your oak wood logs here and just make sure you're connecting all the tops that you can. That's going to make it look a little more structurally sound. And it's just going to make it look a little bit better. Just a little bit. This build looks awesome. Thank you, Maniac Geek. Very, very much. All right, so now let's get to the roof. So the roof is the fun part, right? So we're gonna take these slabs right here and we're gonna go up to a 3 point, so 3 blocks, and then you just bring it back down 2 and you should end up with the even shape like that. Over here, you're gonna go up 2, just like that. And then on the top of this roof right here, so the roof is going to be right here. My brain just completely shut down on me. It was like, nah, we're done working for today. We're gonna go home. See you later, Neo. And that's pretty much how my brain works sometimes. So now we have the basic roof line. The basic roof line. Keep that in mind. Now we're going to grab these slabs here. And we're going to go crazy, okay? So we're going to put a slab on each one of these blocks right there. That's just going to make it simple. Then you want to just drop it down like that. And go all the way around your build. Make sure you square off the edges there. And then you do the same sort of thing right there. And then you do the same thing up here. And that's just going to make this roof a lot easier to build. Once we actually get this little basic outline done. So now what we're going to do is on the bottoms of the blocks, we're just going to connect them like that. And you want to go ahead and just bring that block over just so it connects. So again, you go on the underside and just place it like that. And you make sure that the corners are connected. We shouldn't have to do it anymore, I don't think, except for on the roof here. So we're just going to do the same sort of thing, connecting on the underside, making sure that the squares are connected. Underside, not the squares, but the corners of the roof. There we go. Now the roof is complete. That roof looks very, very nice. Now we're going to need to take some glass panes and we're going to need to do the windows. So this is a starter build, so there's not going to be too many windows in here. And yes, you could definitely do this for a starter build. People are going to be saying like, nah, this isn't a starter, it's too complicated. Well, you know, maybe it takes a couple of days to complete, but it still is technically a starter build because if it's the first house you live in, that would make it a starter, correct? I think so. On the top of this, you just want to fill in these because you don't want your roof showing, or not your roof. You don't want your room showing from the roof. That's never good. We're going to come in here. Actually, we're going to break out these blocks right here. And then we're going to put some stair. We're going to, not stairs, sorry. We're going to put some full blocks, two of them to be exact. And then we're going to bring this down and then round this off and put a couple more. That's just going to make your top area bigger. And it also just adds some like flair to the outside of the build. So now if we come up here and we put our ladder that we broke back, now we have a nice big room up top. Not big, but it's like, you know, big enough for a bedroom. You want to fill in these with slabs as well. So I'm going to grab all the materials we are going to need for the inside, do a one over. And I make sure I didn't miss anything. Nope, everything looks good to me. All right, so I'm gonna grab all the materials we're gonna need for the inside of the build and I'll be right back. One little thing before we get to the inside, don't forget a nice little bedroom window right there. You can see it looks nice. Gives you some nice views of the outside. If you'd like to do the exact same thing on the other side, feel free. It'll just make everything look a little bit better. So now let's get to the inside. First step is going to be, as you walk in, it's gonna be a crafting table right there. Then we're going to do a bunch of chests here. You can do as many as you'd like. We're gonna do a furnace right here, and then we're gonna put a pot. We're gonna put a flower on top. Gonna take some torches here, and we're just gonna put those up here. If you have access to carpet, you can do this. If you don't have access to carpet, don't do it, since it's sort of a starter home, but this is just gonna make it look really nice. So it's gonna make it look more rustic, more home feeling, I guess. And then you can take some wool blocks and the same color, and just bring them down. Maniac just taught me that and it blew my mind. It basically allows you to get more depth in your builds and it just looks a little bit better. So now you just have a nice little carpet in here and just make it look a little bit messier. All right, we can come up top and let's get started on that. So we're gonna have a bed, which I had, but then I replaced with glass panes, I promise. I actually had the bed. I was prepared at one point in the build. I promise I was prepared. Now we're gonna take a crafting table. We're gonna do the same thing with the pot and a blue orchid. Then we're gonna put two torches up here for lighting. We're gonna come down here. We already did the torches. So that's pretty much the interior of the build. It's not something like super, super fancy. And that is honestly just because it is a starter build. It's not supposed to be like some exquisite interior that looks awesome, but you guys can go crazy with it. You guys could make it bigger, smaller, whatever you guys wanna do. But thank you guys so much for watching. If we could get 1,000 likes on this video, that would be super, super awesome. I would love that. That would make my entire week. And I think that would just be cool if you guys could show me some support. If you guys did not like the video, I do ask, to be honest, leave a dislike, but if you do that, I do ask that you leave a comment explaining why you disliked it, so I can cater my content more to you guys and make things a little bit better for you to watch. But yeah, if you guys want to know what shader pack, texture pack, all that fancy stuff is all in the description below, so if you guys are curious about that, it's all down there. If you're not subscribed to me and you want to subscribe, click that subscribe button, you get notified when I upload, click that bell. Turn on those post notifications and you'll know when I upload. But yeah, I'll thank you guys a final time for watching and I'll see you guys in the next tutorial. All right, bye.